Uh-oh, back on the hoist again. This seems to be acting up. It came on, along with the ABS light, and along with the traction control light on. And then it says, service four-wheel drive system. So I don't know what the heck is going on with this. And then also the engine check engine light has been on for a while. So to our surprise, underneath the engine cover, there was a rat's nest beginning. And then also the wheel speed sensor, pants here is working like the dickens, getting that done. Because we knew that one was bad.
Pulled it out without breaking it. But yeah, pull it.
And we'll save those glow plugs for in the future, because if one glow plug goes out, then we can just pop in another one, right? So there's still...
probably not all bad.
Yeah, only one was actually bad, but now we have five extra ones to use in the future. So we can just, if you know, one does go bad, then we can just plop in another one and they'll be good to go.
The other half of the plug.
Yeah, there's the other half, so... yeah, hopefully we'll get this Jeep up and going again. The wife right now is running the 04 with two car seats, and it's just a regular cab, right? So anyways, we'll have to make do with what we have to work with. So here's the old wheel speed sensor. There's the new one. You can see it's been rubbing. So
got her own one piece though, even though she's junk. Very proud of myself.
Wow, look at this. This is pretty cool. It tells you everything about your ECM. This program, this app, is called Torque. So yeah, you just spell Torque in your Android or Apple device. I'm not sure if they have one for BlackBerry. But anyways, yeah, what I did was, on eBay, I bought one of those ODB connectors with the Bluetooth. So let me show you here. You can do different things with this ODB adapter. So yeah, you can get one of those ODB2 links, or one of these. I bought that one there, the cheap eBay adapter. I think it was around the $30 mark delivered. And I think it came right from China, or I don't know, it had Chinese lettering, I think, on my PayPal account. Anyways, go to show logged fault codes, and so it's just scanning the ECM right now and bringing up the problem codes. So anyways, what we've done to this Jeep so far, there's the plug-in right there, and it's blinking yellow, so it's a good and green as well. It took a while to pair with my device. Like, it paired it, but it still took a while to connect. But anyways, what I did was I brought up the codes here, and I went through each one of the codes before I made the trip down to Rodney. And anyways, I'm just going through each one of the codes, and so let's say it's problem code cylinder 7 misfire detected. Okay, so I go to web if I want to know more information about this, and I'll just say, let's see. Whoops, one-handed here. Powertrain ignition system or misfire. So engine running. Then the PCM detected a misfire condition. Lack of spark or fuel metering base engine. Okay, so it could have been anything really. It could have been, a little hiccup here. But, well, that's for Ford or generic. So I don't even have 7 cylinders. This has 6 cylinders. So I don't know what that is, but maybe that's not applicable for this. Because this is the 3-liter diesel, the Mercedes diesel, right? So anyways, let's go back here. Anyways, I just have the free version of this. If you get the paid version, you can do so much more stuff with this. I'm very happy with this thing. This is very cool. Like, and when I was driving, all this was all, the speed and everything was pretty accurate. There was a little bit of a lag time there. But anyways, now that I've replaced the wheel speed sensor on this, and then I've also changed all 6 glow plugs. Anyways, this is a really... should only perform this action after the fault has been fixed and your vehicle is stationary. Are you sure you want to clear the fault log? Okay.
Cleared the codes, and we're going to take this for a test spin. So here's a vehicle running, and it's going to take it. So what I did was I replaced all the glow plugs, right? And replaced the right rear wheel speed sensor. You could see that it got damaged. So anyways, that was throwing all the codes. The four-wheel drive system was not happy at all. And now I just cleared all the codes. There's four codes. Cylinder 7 misfire. This doesn't have a 7 cylinder. So anyways, look at this thing. Okay, and then it'll tell you, like, look, if I 100% throttle, and it'll put 900% load on the engine. It's okay, it's four-wheel drive.
Read it off.
So anyways, now the engine light is not coming back on. That four-wheel drive system is happy now because it's able to communicate with all the wheels. So now it even has the temperatures and all that stuff, how hot the engine is, you know.
Sensor.
Isn't that awesome?
It works good.
Now I'm gonna see if it's gonna work for my Volkswagens because they have their own special.
Yeah, VAG.
Yeah, so I don't know if it'll work or not, but I guess we'll find out.